pointers, concept code number 5. In this particular program, we're going to try to determine the size of different objects like integers, characters, single pointers, pointer to a pointer, and so on. I have declared an integer variable si with the value 100. I have declared a character ch with the initial value g. They are represented here. Si has the initial value 100, ch has the initial value g. Now what has happened is, si resides at address 100, ch resides at address 102. Now I have declared a variable iptr which is of the type single star. That means it's a pointer to an integer type of variable. Thereby it contains the address of si. Address of si is what? 100, because 100 is the address of si. Similarly, cptr is a pointer to a character type of data. It contains the address of ch. What is address of ch? It is 102. So cptr contains the address 102. Now both iptr and cptr themselves being variables, they have addresses 1000 and 1004 respectively. Now after that, I have int pointer to a pointer diptr and char pointer to a pointer dcptr. How I am representing them? I am representing them using double boxes so that you understand that they are a pointer to a pointer. Since they are a pointer to a pointer, diptr we will assume exists at address 1008, dcptr exists at address 1012. Then in the next step, what I am doing is, in step number 2, I am giving the address of iptr to diptr. So iptr is at address 1000, that 1000 comes here. CPTR is at address 1004, so 1004 gets assigned to DCPTR, as you can see here. Now let us try to understand the size of different data types. The size of int on this machine I can assume to be 2 bytes, although generally it is 4 bytes. So if you look at the size of int, when I print %ALU%ALU, size of int and size of character, size of int is going to print 2 or 4 or 8 depending on the machine. Size of character is always going to print 1. Unsigned int, so that this size of returns an unsigned long, and I'm printing it with %ALU. That's why I have explicitly typecast it using unsigned long. Now what I am doing here is, I am trying to print the value referred by iptr and the value referred by cptr. IPTR is containing 100, CPTR is containing 102. Because it is a star, star indicates value at address 100. Value at address 100 is the number integer 100. Value at address 102, value at the address 102 happens to be the character G. So size of 100 and size of G is going to be 2 and 1 again. So you can see that size of int and size of, sorry, char is again 2 and 1 bytes respectively, based on the assumptions I have made. Although they can be 4 and 8 for integer and 1 of course for character variable always. Now let me tell you how we find the size of pointer type of variables. In my example, iptr is at 1000th location, cptr is at 1004th location. That means there is a difference of 4 bytes. DIPTR is at 1008, DCPTR is at 1012. That means this particular numbers tell me that the size of each of my pointer type of variable happens to be 4 bytes. Although generally on most of the machines you are going to work, it's going to be 8 bytes. A little bit of explanation is important here. If the size of my pointer variable is just 1 bit, I can basically refer to 2 addresses. If it is 2 bits, I can refer to 4 addresses. If it is 3 bits, I can refer to 8 addresses. If it is 4 bits, I can refer to 0 to 15, 16 addresses. If it is 8 bits, I can refer to 0 to 255 addresses. If it is 16 bits, I can refer to from 0 to 65,000 odd kilobytes of addresses. If it is 32 bits, I can refer for address starting from 0 to 4 gigabytes. And if the pointer variable, which is generally of 8 bytes, then you can refer from starting address from 0 to 18 exabytes, which is a humongous or a huge amount of memory to be referred by pointers. So pointer size depend on machine to machine. So if I'm trying to print the size of IPTR and CPTR, so you will notice that they are given 4 bytes. So it's going to print 4 and 4 on my particular machine on this paper. Whereas actually when I'm doing a demo of this particular program on online GDB compiler, you will see size of IPTR as 8, size of CPTR is also 8. Then what I'm doing is in the last step, I'm trying to print the size of a pointer to a pointer kind of a variable. Just the word pointer to pointer should not scare you. What a pointer to pointer means, only the first star will give you an address. The second star will give you the value 100. So size of DIPTR is also 4. Size of DCPTR is also 4. So if you're going to see the output, it's going to be 4 and 4. To get a better understanding of this concept code 5, please take a look at the following demo of the code, this particular code which has been executed, so you will really understand all these address and size concepts very well.